cannot believe this superstar would stoop this low.
Guys, I don't even think this match is going to be able to begin.
Yeah, this competitor completely just throwing the rule book out the window.
That arm might need medical attention.
Finally, these superstars have made it to the ring after a vicious surprise attack while entering.
I gotta imagine that brutal assault has taken some kind of toll, though.
Yeah, as this match goes on, the lasting effects of that attack might become a factor.
He knew that was coming.
Drop kick!
Ooh!
That hit connects from Sami Zayn.
To the arm.
Hyperextend your elbow.
Stomp after stomp after stomp.
You have to imagine the disdain it takes to repeatedly stomp someone like that. Impressive sequence from Sami Zayn.
Sami Zayn has got everything going exactly how he wants it.
Targeting the arm with a big stomp.
Oh, here we go. Brainbuster.
Landing like that can do some lasting damage to the spine.
And no chiropractor has a cure for what we just saw.
And now the admittingly divisive Sami Zayn attempting to rally the WWE Universe behind him. I'm not sure if it's really worth the trouble, though, Sammy.
And Cross can't find an answer for these attacks.
Yeah, but Cross just has to revert back to his killer instincts to regain control.
And how does one go about defeating Sami Zayn, or at the very least, shutting him up?
Your disrespect is noted, but unlike some people, I'm going to maintain my journalistic integrity. Sami's a world-traveled competitor with a ton of intelligence, but you may be able to frustrate him and cause the Great Liberator to make a mistake.
Thrown back in under the ropes.
Uh-oh, this is not going to look pretty. Submission being applied.
Good job getting on the ropes there.
Yeah, that could have been bad.
Does he get out of here? No, he gets the shoulder up.
I didn't think we'd see a kick out there.
Headbutt to the back of the neck. One step ahead. Cross.
Sami Zayn looking for it.
Sami Zayn, Blue Thunderbomb.
And we've seen how this rivalry is escalating to the point that no one involved cares about the collateral damage they've caused.
Hell, Michael.
Oh, kick by Zayn. Has Sami ended it there?
Emotions running high, and Byron, I'm not quite sure this is what we expected to see.
Okay, this is not needed. This is uncalled for. With a steel chill to the arm. Repeated shots.
Winning clearly wasn't enough for this superstar. It's about taking out their opponent altogether.
Now, this is too much, Corey. This is way too far.
Lucha Libre legend in the flesh has an undeniable legacy in sports entertainment.
The following contest is a triple threat match. Making his way to the ring, representing the NWO from San Diego, California, weighing in at 175 pounds, Rey
Mysterio has the ability to mix up styles at a moment's notice, and yet always finds a way to win.
Irish ace, ready for a fight.
And his opponents, first representing the Judgment Day, from Bray, County Wicklow, Ireland, weighing in at 180 pounds, J.D. McDonagh.
J.D. McDonagh is an Irish nobleman who walks with an air of distinction. And tonight, he's looking to throw hands.
Yeah, McDonagh's been on a rocket launch-like trajectory ever since entering NXT.
He has these chilling eyes, just a stare. Stares right through you, and he's able to dismantle all comers.
McDonagh possesses skills so far beyond, you have no choice but to become a believer.
J.D. McDonagh is a competitor who changes the landscape wherever he competes.
Listen, he'll attack if he senses even the slightest fear or trepidation.
Hey, J.D., fear and trepidation, to my left. Look at Saxton.
Quiet, Corey!
Saxton, this dude knows what it's like on the streets. He's not a character. This is reality in and out of the ring.
Flashy moves in his arsenal.
Yeah, Shanti's a guy who loves to flaunt his skills in the ring.
Triple threat matchup, and it's going to be Rey Mysterio, J.D. McDonagh, and Ashante the Adonis.
Always a feeling out process in the early goings of a triple threat. You want to gauge your distance. You want to know just how much real estate you can have to yourself. You don't want to be the first one targeted because things can snowball against you quickly. Big
Uh-oh. This isn't going to be pretty. Suplex!
Targeting the neck, and here it comes. Boom! What a neck breaker.
Set right into the corner.
Followed in with a clothesline. Watch the athleticism. Satellite DDT.
Oh, what an elbow high on the chin. Well, that'll do some serious damage.
Jarring European uppercut.
Look, I know it may sound cliche, but with triple threat matches, you've always got to keep your head on a swivel. Always got to know when to pick your spot. Even if you form an alliance, it won't last. That's just the nature of the game.
Vicious right forearm.
Boom! What a right! Sure, he's popping himself up, but he's also giving his opponent a chance to recover.
She's taking is starting to pile up.
From behind.
And he breaks up the pinfall.
Look at that, Saxton. He's running away.
I wouldn't say that. He's just recomposing himself.
Oh, man. Spine-crushing impact.
DDT.
And the cover. Quick count after one.
Surprised to not even get a two count at this point.
Great athleticism.
Oh, man, inverted backbreaker.
Ow. for something here. Exhibiting a crazy amount of strength here.
By the way, takedown. Crushing double stop.
He's lost some of his win now. Little man in WWE history is standing tall.
Uh-oh.
The arms are hooked. Tiger suplex. Looking for the victory.
Double leg takedown. Crushing double stop. Hooked up. DDT.
Into the corner he goes. A perfectly placed target. Gotta hurt.
Dismantling the arm in the corner.
The arm absorbing the damage. Solid punch.
JD cut open, but we've seen before that the Irish ace doesn't mind at all.
This match is brutality starting to show on him.
I'm just surprised that this triple threat match is still going on. I bet Saxton this would have been over by now.
Devil inside. Ooh. Oh my! Top they go for the Rowdy Buster.
Can you believe this?
I love it.
Will Adonis finish things now?
Pin's broken up.
I can't believe it.
Mysterio sent flying.
Mysterio telling his opponent no side difference is going to make Ray back down.
He's looking for an implement of destruction under the ring. He's in a little bit of trouble now.
This should come as no surprise. In a havoc-filled triple threat, you're going to take some big hits.
Got to find a way to get out of this. Just hold on a second. Could be a matter of time. Submission being locked in.
Drop the arm and is testing its tensile strength.
Will this match end on a submission, on a tap out?
In this much pain, even an iron will might not be strong enough.
Sweeps the legs. Crushing double stop.
Oh, man, you can see he is feeling it now.
Splash! Is that an easy roll for McDonough?
Captain's hook.
Locked in.
Can you imagine what it would do to
him? Trouble here.
Chin lock back to his feet now. Elbow going to create some separation. Mysterio has him hooked. Oh, this is going to be great. Looking for the second and now perhaps.
Three amigo style by Rey Mysterio.
Up the count. Left side. Spine buster. And there's the breakup. Just in the nick of time. Ooh, that hurt right to the kidney.
Golly.
Goodness. Somersault reverse DDT. Drop kick.
Well-delivered suplex.
Uh-oh. The power, the strength.
Dominator.
stops the count. Oh, he's got him by the leg.
Foot DDT.
I don't think any of these superstars are going to show any quit at this point.
Never say die attitude on full display. Yeah. He's in a precarious situation.
He's headed up top.
Thinking big.
Going for it again. Triple threat match.
I cannot even imagine how any of these men feel after a match like that.
All I can really say is that they put on a triple threat match for the ages. Superstar has stated that conquering Roman Reigns is his destiny.
Here comes the head of the table.
Guess what, folks? It's time to acknowledge the Tribal Chief.
And his opponent from Pensacola, Florida, weighing in at 265 pounds, the undisputed WWE Universal Champion, Roman Reigns!
Here's a man who's held the Universal Championship for over 2 years.
Greatness redefined. That's God mode.
When you see a superstar like Roman Reigns, you see a man who seems practically untouchable.
Exactly, Saxton, like a god, an immortal.
Part of the pantheon of all-time greats in the WWE. You can count on one hand the amount of people who held the championship as long as Roman Reigns. No time to panic. You have to maintain focus on the sinister Finn Balor to have any chance in this match.
If you've got nervous butterflies, get rid of them now.
I've always questioned Finn Balor's motives, but there's no mistaking what his intentions are these days.
Yeah, Michael, the selfishness and animosity we've seen from Finn Balor has really put a sour taste in the mouths of the WWE Universe. I understand that he is concentrating on taking care of himself, but I don't think this ruthless attitude is the answer.
Yeah, and we have to start asking how far Finn Balor is willing to push this and what his endgame is.
And with Roman Reigns as your
nap time on the island of relevancy, you can see hope for Balor begin.
Oh, and he gets out. Perhaps some renewed life in him now. Oh, slight blade. Followed up with a
basement drop kick.
Saw that coming.
Set for a ride.
Taking a trip outside, but he's got to be mindful of the count.
DDT!
Fight.
A lot of people have criticized Roman Reigns for relying too much on his cronies to maintain his standing in WWE. Corey, do you consider that a possible sign of weakness from Reigns?
Absolutely not, Cole, because Reigns doesn't need to rely on anyone but himself in the ring. He is where he is because he's the Tribal Chief. He's proven repeatedly that he has what it takes to get things done on his own.
Oh, across the top rope.
Referee's count only getting higher.
Come on, gotta get back in the ring.
Really challenging the Tribal Chief with that.
And with that move, I'd say Balor's ruthlessness will be key to his success.
Getting him into the corner.
Balor in full control of his opponent. Setting up. Shotgun.
He's going for the pin. This could be it. Is this enough? No, it isn't. He kicked out. He kicked out.
Both competitors digging into wells they didn't even know existed.
I thought we saw this reach the boiling point already, but boy, was I wrong.
Well, that shouldn't be a new feeling for you, Saxton.
You should try being right once in a while, Byron. It feels good.
A beatdown.
And Balor up top. Finn got all of it.
That's gotta be it.
There's two.
Oh, he just kicked out.
The Tribal Chief digging down deep and fighting through it.
You might not respect his methods, but you have to respect his determination.
And now's the time where Finn needs to keep the pedal to the metal, sustain his offense. He's looking a little weary now.
Might be the start of Balor turning up the heat.
Knife edge chop and a drop kick to follow.
Going way up high.
Perched up top.
And nobody's there.
And a Oof. Stop to the gut, too.
Yeah.
Kick to the gut.
Boom! DDT. Oh, strong impact. Oh, jeez. Oh, Roman Reigns locked and loaded, measuring his opponent. Here we go.
Cannot keep Finn down.
For the win. Two. Oh, not yet. They just got the shoulder up.
A truly extraordinary kick out by Finn Balor.
And Reigns absolutely can't believe it, but he cannot let that slow him down.
Dominating shoulder tackle.
Reigns establishing the upper hand.
Reigns just emphasizing that he can get this done all by himself, proving just why no one else can lay the claim to being the tribal chief.
Makes him pay with a counter.
Nothing fancy, but very effective.
Looking for, yeah, the inverted figure four leg lock.
Left by the turnbuckles. Reigns turns that around.
Punch! Finn Balor with the door right now. He can really stand to get back as good as he's getting right about now. It's been a hard-hitting affair here tonight.
These competitors are going to have trouble walking on their own after this one.
Saw that one coming.
Arms trap.
Precision strikes.
The WWE Universe really these superstars are.
Pumping the adrenaline they so desperately need right now.
Launch out to the outside.
That's finding any which way to topple the competition.
Hurling your own body like that is insane.
Play is so close to our announce table.
Yeah, I'm just going to step aside now.
Hey, wait for me.
Hooked up. DDT.
Uh-oh, this is just vicious.
No, that'll break his arm. Vicious. And Balor somehow just keeps laying in more and more offense.
Yeah, Roman has had so much thrown his way. So much he's had to endure.
And he gets sent back into the ring.
From the ground up.
Oh, an incredible seated suplex.
Retaliated with a head-turning clothesline. He went right into that turnbuckle.
Superman punch! And that was an efficient display of offense with that maneuver.
No coming back from Reigns after that.
An upset! An absolute upset!
I am in disbelief. I still don't know if what we saw was
superstar has completely lost it.
Here comes the double champion,
the woman with all the gold.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring from Dublin, Ireland, the NXT Women's Champion, Becky Lynch!
Winning a women's title in WWE already means you're at the top of the industry, so what does two titles indicate?
It means we're in the presence of an all-time great competitor.
Every day she holds both titles, every time she successfully defends them, she is making her case as the GOAT of the women's division.
The women's division has never been this competitive, and somehow she's been able to amass multiple titles.
And we are truly seeing a once-in-a-lifetime talent, and the proof is in her hands.
accompanied by Dominic Mysterio, representing the Judgment Day. From Adelaide, Australia, Rhea Ripley.
The WWE Universe already reaching a fever pitch upon their arrival, and we are just seconds away from a highly anticipated match.
Rhea Ripley has truly become the walking embodiment of brutality. She displays a viciousness that's just on another level. When you get in the ring with Ripley, things are guaranteed to get ugly.
And that's just the way she wants it. Rhea has fully embraced the darkness inside her and unleashes it on her opponents to great effect. But the suffering she inflicts can be downright barbaric at times.
No doubt we'll see that wicked streak of hers on full display here.
But she will definitely have her work cut out for her against Becky Lynch. Becky knows what it takes to defy the odds, to go face-to-face with the very best and come out on top. This might be a challenge for her, but there's nothing Becky appreciates more than a challenge.
Textbook vertical suplex. Bam. And we might be about to go from commentators to participants in this one, fellas.
Down with the vertical suplex.
Bad things looming for Becky.
Clubbing blow to the back. Brought back into the ring from the floor now. Trying to dislocate the shoulder.
Scratching and clawing, this could be it.
And she thwarts the pin attempt in one.
Somehow still has the energy for a quick kick out.
We all know Becky Lynch is talented when it comes to submitting opponents, but Corey, you have to have more in your arsenal to win matches.
Well, that's a good thing. Becky brings a whole lot more to the table. She has a wide arsenal of attacks that could help her get this match won. In fact, the more moves she uses, the better for Becky in this one.
Pretty drop kick.
Setting up. Uh-oh, the inverted figure four leg lock. That's gotta hurt.
Looking bad for her here.
Look out! Suicide dive!
It's like a heat-seeking missile coming at you.
And the explosion occurring ringside.
Two.
Oh, man. And an elbow drop, too?
Ripley in a surprising bit of danger.
Look at Lynch go, calling on her wide arsenal of attacks to put together some effective offense.
She's going up.
Top rope here, up high. Nobody home for that one.
Oh, Lord.
The end for Lynch could be on its way.
As an opponent,
wow, just as effective as her opponent.
Two count, three.
Just had a taste of her own medicine. Survived it, but she doesn't want another dose.
Ripley needs to become a little bit more brutal to close this one out. The physicality on display there. Unbelievable.
And a reversal by Becky Lynch.
Rhea had that scouted. Sent into the corner.
Oh, look at this aggression in the corner.
Yeah.
Becky's looking to go airborne.
From the top! There's the goal line. Cover!
There's two!
So, so close. That could have been it. Becky Lynch, herself up.
Handle slam.
Is it the finishing touch Lynch needs?
Makes the cover! And she's still in the game.
This match should be over. Ripley has more guts than brains.
And Becky Lynch is fuming. She did all that work and still it wasn't enough.
Has the arm into a hammerlock cinched in.
Heads out of the ring, but needs to be mindful of the referee's count here. Impressive reversal there.
Defenses are sharp in this series of reversals.
Reverse DDT. Here's the pump handle. Suplex.
Launched.
And that holds Becky back.
A little psychological warfare at play here from the Nightmare.
This match is coming down to the last second. Someone's got to get back to the ring now.
This match may be nearing its limit.
She is barely standing at this point.
She throws her back in.
Four.
Five. Uh-oh. Carefully measured.
Big leg drop.
Becky's showing no restraint.
Ripley needs to be resourceful. Find an opening.
This is a unique application of a hammerlock.
Looking to take flight here.
She's trying so desperately to get back up to her feet.
From the top.
Wow. Becky added a little something extra there.
She stepped up to this challenge and is letting
into the cover.
Your winner.
Let's look back on the action from the last match.
Here is your winner, Becky Lynch.
That is the kind of win that opens eyes here in WWE.
A major victory here.
She was so committed to walking out the winner, I'm not sure anything could have stopped her.
Welcome to the Uso Penitentiary.
The following is a tag team match set for one fall. Introducing first, representing the Usos from San Francisco, California, weighing in at 251 pounds, Jimmy Uso!
Hey, Jimmy's been helping to run things in the bloodline.
Jimmy Uso may not be alongside his brother Jay here tonight, but Jimmy Uso is just as cunning as ever.
Hey, superb athletic abilities here.
You can say that again. Jimmy Uso has the ability to fly around the ring and still hit like a truck.
Honestly, guys, Jimmy Uso is the complete package.
I've never agreed more, Byron.
Looking at the future of the bloodline.
And his partner from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in at 250 pounds, Solo Sikoa.
Had a meteoric rise in NXT, multiple main event matches, and the NXT North American title.
And has already made an impact on the main roster, becoming a part of the bloodline.
When it comes to the street champion, Solo always puts that title on the line.
combined weight of 503 pounds, Damian Priest and Drew McIntyre, the Judgment Day.
My sources tell me that the entire tag team division is watching this one backstage. That's how important this match is.
Teams in their respective corners, we're going to get a chance to see Solo Sikoa and Jimmy Uso. Of course, you can't count out the opposition here, as you see Damian Priest and Drew McIntyre.
The trust is key to victory in a match like this. If you don't have a tag partner you can rely on, you might as well pack it in now.
Ooh, treading all over their opponent.
Ooh.
Strikes with a kick. He's stalking his opponent from the top turnbuckle.
Up high!
Body from the top!
The switch here to Drew McIntyre.
There's the takedown. Tagged into action.
Shut up, Saxton. This is just a small regrouping. Side slam.
Nice.
What a punch.
Solid reverses and looks to capitalize.
Shot after shot.
Ruthless striking. Yes. Boom. Nice.
Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless.
Enough already.
He's tagging out.
Shot. Ooh, ruthless striking.
Punch lands. And Drew's starting to really feel the effects of this matchup as it goes on.
And yeah, it's about time to heavily consider tagging in that partner.
Capitalizing on Sikoa's mistake. In off the tag.
Slam the door yet.
Hoist it up.
Nice suplex.
Vertical suplex.
Oh, wicked kick to the lower back.
This is starting to reach Cain and Abel levels of animosity, guys.
Jeez, Cole, I hope it doesn't go that far.
Yeah, I don't think I can stomach that.
Placing them right where they want them, into the corner.
Clothesline
with their head.
partner for the tag.
Oh, wiped out with the crossbody. Tag is made, and he's coming in hot. Well-executed takedown.
Control and aggression, something they'll want to keep up.
Oh, flipping the script on him there. Oh, the reversal by Priest. Damian Priest, crucifix.
Crucifix powerbomb. This could be it.
Cover for the win.
And he makes the save for his team.
Priest has him lined up, and back elbow creates separation.
Hopped up, into the submission trap, incredible.
And a tag there.
He skirts around it.
Damian Priest has got him set up. He's starting to struggle here.
Yeah, they stuck it out through this match, but it wouldn't hurt to go for the tag soon here.
Whoa! Two.
Sakura prevents that from connecting.
Double slam. Watch it! They're coming towards the announce desk.
What the hell are you doing, Byron?
Hammering down on the knee.
Damian veering his attention away from the match. Not the best idea. He's testing fate here in danger of a countout. Oh, right in the mat, face first.
That certainly wasn't pretty.
Oh, they back up. They're getting too close for comfort.
Well, no one's paying attention to you, Saxon. They're too busy beating the tar out of each other.
Priest is picking the cup.
Got it. There's the winners of the tag match.
Here are your winners, Damian Priest and Drew McIntyre.
And they were not able to beat the ref's count. This one ends in a countout.
I hate a countout. I feel cheated, and I